Thank you. The senior director of the Punjas in Tampa, Mr. Andy Kuda. Honorable ministers, other members of the Punjas family, the executive and staff of the Punjas group of companies, my fellow Fijians, Bulaganaka, and a very good afternoon to you all. I'm delighted to be back in Lautoka this afternoon, as I always am, to officially open the new Punjas Medical Center here at the Waiyavi subdivision in the Sugar City. For those of you who do not know, this happens to be the fourth new or refurbished health facility that I've opened in the West in the last 3 days. And of course, it's a clear sign of my government's determination to significantly improve the healthcare outcomes of the Fijian people, especially here in the West, especially in the most important part of the country, which contributes so much to our national economy and the prosperity of every Fijian. There is, however, one feature about this center I'm opening today, which makes it uniquely different from the others I launched this week at Wotukarasa in Zugu and the new extension at the Singotoka Hospital, and that is that the entire cost of the building of this facility, $500,000, has been borne by the Punjan Sons family through their charitable trust. It is a wonderful gesture, wonderful act of generosity on the part of this family and the Punjan Sons group of companies. And I want to say a heartfelt thank you to them on behalf of the Fijian government and the Fijian people. I want to pay special tribute to Mr. Kandi Punja, the company's senior director, who envisaged this project and has been the driving force in getting it completed. It has taken 2 years of hard work, but is yet another wonderful testament to the role that the Punja family and the Punjas group have played in Fiji since the company was founded in Dubu in 1935. Today, we celebrate 80 years of service by this Fijian company to the nation. It is also a wonderful thing that Mr. Kandi Punja celebrates his 80th birthday this year. And for his lifetime of service and for the great gesture he has made to improve the health of the people of Lautoka through this facility, I again ask you all to give him a special round of applause. This is also a day to celebrate a wonderful partnership between government and the private sector, because while the Punja Group has paid for this facility, it is the government that will resource it through the doctors and nurses of the Ministry of Health. From today, the people of Lautoka have a choice in whether to come here or go to the Lautoka Hospital, which we all know is under pressure because of the demand of its services. This facility will do a great deal to relieve some of the pressure, so it is a valuable addition to the health infrastructure of the Sugar City and its citizens. The Punjas Medical Center has been specially designed with the needs of the people with disabilities in mind, with easy access to its consultation rooms, changing rooms, and shower and toilet facilities. So the design of the center is as thoughtful as a gesture of providing it itself. I'm told that about 29,000 people will benefit directly from this health center, providing them with general health care, maternal and child health care, and specialist attention for mental health patients. While we celebrate the generosity of the Punja family, I would like to take this opportunity to appeal to other businesses throughout Fiji to consider following the lead that they and other families like the Tapus have set in devoting themselves to community projects. In a number of countries, corporate and private philanthropy that is giving money to charity is well established, and it would be great to see more of the same thing happening in Fiji. The fact is that government can only do so much even with the assistance of our international aid partners. But working hand in hand with the private sector, we can obviously do so much more. This kind of partnership isn't about politics. It's about supporting every Fijian, whoever they are, in whichever way they voted. So I urge Fijian businesses to rise above and not be worried about the petty politics and personalization of views and of issues and matters we too often see from the opposition. I urge the business houses to work with and partner with government to charitable, social, and national endeavors. Our economy is on a trajectory, and through our combined efforts, we can achieve a lot more, not just as individual stakeholders, but also as an entire community and as an entire nation. So I encourage you all, once again, to follow the example of the Punjas group of companies and others, and to make more of a contribution to the common good. With those words, ladies and gentlemen, honorable ministers, I have great pleasure in once again thanking the Punja family and their group and declaring the Punjas Medical Center open. Inaugurable.
I'm safe to walk around.
Yes.